Welcome back to Jerusalem Dateline. For the past 65 years, one of Israel's biggest challenges has been a chronic water shortage. But this year, for the first time in modern history, the nation's water authority declared that Israel has officially beat the drought. And in fact, that Israelis may soon have a water surplus. Here's a look at the innovative techniques that have helped boost Israel's water supply.
More than half of this country's land is desert, and we have a severe water shortage. Moses led us to Israel, a country that has no oil, no water, not too good soil, and we had to make the best out of it.
Thousands of years ago, Moses had to strike a rock to get water in the desert. Well, today Israelis are taking a slightly different approach, using technology and creativity. In Israel, the main sources of drinking water are the Sea of Galilee and two underground aquifers. If rainfall is short, so is the nation's water supply. In 1953, Israel started building the National Water Carrier, a system of pipelines, canals, and reservoirs that carry water from the Sea of Galilee to the rest of Israel.
So we didn't have water? Okay, we developed water technology. One of the things that Israel has excelled in is taking what some people would see as risk factors or as curses and turning them into blessings. From the time of Bilam, Jewish people have always been able to somehow turn the curse into a blessing.
The pipelines were a good start, but Israel's fresh water supply wasn't enough to support a growing country. So Israelis started looking west to the Mediterranean.
For thousands of years, the Mediterranean Sea was the center of the ancient world, the crossroads between Europe, Asia, and Africa. And now it's one of Israel's greatest natural resources.
Israel is desalinating so much of its drinking water, the majority of our drinking water's origin will be the Mediterranean Sea by the end of next year.
Today, Israel produces 450 million cubic meters of drinkable water a day through a process called seawater reverse osmosis. Water can go from the ocean to the faucet in less than 90 minutes. The Israeli technology is now used in more than 40 countries around the world. And thanks to the Mediterranean, Israel may soon have something that was once unthinkable, a water surplus.
In this country, we don't have much water, except somehow, by the end of this decade, Israel is going to become a net water exporter. Just on today's news, there was an item about how Israel is stepping up the export of water to Jordan in order to supply water for all the Syrian refugees who are fleeing into Jordan.
While Israel produces drinking water from the sea, many farmers are getting water for their crops literally out of thin air. Ancient Israelites used stones to collect the dew every morning. Now an Israeli company is using plastic trays to do the same. The trays were developed by Talyad Technologies, which means God's dew in Hebrew. Every morning, these trays channel the dew straight into the roots of the plants. They also prevent weeds from growing between the plants and reduce water usage by up to 50%. Israeli farmers have always made good use of their water. But it wasn't long before they realized that in order to survive, they also needed to start reusing it.
Today, Israel recycles 80% of its wastewater. The closest competitor is Spain with 10%. So we recycle more than 8 times more water than any other country on the planet.
Israelis developed a way to purify wastewater using ultraviolet light. This treated water is then used to irrigate crops.
If you use it for vegetables, then you'd like to clean it to the extent that you can almost drink it. So it is treated to a very high degree. Today, 60% of the water that is irrigating fields in Israel is produced water and not natural water. And I'll give you an example of our farm here on the kibbutz. We grow jojoba and we use only sewage water, only treated wastewater to irrigate our jojoba. And this is done all over Israel.